Have you ever seen an octopus that can imitate the shape and color of a sea snake, or a fly that resembles a dangerous bee? This incredible phenomenon is called mimicry, one of nature's most spectacular survival strategies. Mimicry is the ability of one species to imitate the appearance, sounds, or behavior of another species to gain evolutionary advantages. In the animal kingdom, mimicry has evolved over millions of years as a response to intense natural selection pressures. This strategy allows animals to avoid predators, capture prey more effectively, or even deceive potential mates. Biologically, the diversity of mimicry can be categorized into several main types with unique characteristics. These categories emerge as evolutionary responses to natural selection pressures in specific ecosystems, such as interspecies competition or predator avoidance needs. The most famous type of mimicry is Batesian mimicry, named after English naturalist Henry Walter Bates. In this strategy, harmless species mimic the appearance of dangerous or unpalatable species. A classic example is the hoverfly mimicking bees. Hoverflies are harmless flies without stingers, yet they've evolved yellow-black striped coloration like bees or wasps. When predators such as birds see this color pattern, they assume they're facing a dangerous stinging insect and choose to avoid it. Another fascinating example is the caterpillar of the hemiplane's Triptolemus morph, which mimics a venomous snake. When threatened, it inflates the front part of its body, revealing patterns that resemble large eyes, and even moves like a snake ready to strike. This dramatic disguise convinces predators to stay away, even though the caterpillar is completely harmless. Unlike Batesian mimicry, Mullerian mimicry involves two or more dangerous species that mimic each other. This strategy is named after German zoologist Fritz Muller and is mutualistic. It means both species benefit from the resemblance. The basic concept is simple yet brilliant. When multiple dangerous species share similar appearances, predators only need to learn from one bad experience to avoid all species with that appearance. One example of Mullerian mimicry is the viceroy butterfly, which has nearly identical wing patterns and colors to the monarch butterfly. Both have a bitter taste, which can make predators, such as birds, uncomfortable after eating them. The monarch acquires this trait from the poison of the milkweed plant it eats as a caterpillar, while the viceroy derives its protection from a different, bitter chemical compound. Their similar appearance allows predators to quickly recognize and avoid both. Interestingly, various bee and wasp species also display Mullerian mimicry with similar yellow-black patterns. All have painful stings, and by sharing the same warning pattern, they collectively reduce the risk of predator attacks. Aggressive mimicry is the opposite of defensive strategies. Here, predators disguise themselves as harmless species to approach prey. This is the true wolf in sheep's clothing strategy, where hunters disguise themselves to deceive their victims. One of the most remarkable examples is the Phytorus firefly females, known as femmes fatales. These fireflies mimic the mating signals of Photinus females to attract Photinus males. When the unfortunate males approach expecting mating, they end up as dinner instead. Even more amazingly, some Phytorus species can mimic various signals from different species, like predators that can speak in multiple languages to attract different types of prey. Another example is the spider-tailed horned viper, which has a tail that looks like a spider. The tip of its tail wiggles like prey in motion, attracting insect-eating birds that mistake it for a meal. Once the bird gets close, the snake strikes swiftly and devours it. This unique adaptation makes the viper an exceptionally effective predator in its habitat. Mimicry doesn't appear overnight. It's the result of evolutionary processes spanning millions of years through natural selection. Animals with even slight resemblance to dangerous models have better survival chances. Over time, this resemblance continues to be refined until reaching the levels we see today. Interestingly, mimicry isn't always perfect, and there's a reason for this. Predators have cognitive limitations and time constraints in decision-making. Under time pressure, predators tend to avoid anything resembling dangerous models, even if the resemblance isn't perfect. This explains why many imperfect mimics still successfully survive. Recent research shows that climate change also affects mimicry effectiveness. The emergence patterns of mimics and models can change, creating new evolutionary pressures that affect the sustainability of mimicry systems. Mimicry teaches us about the extraordinary power of natural selection and evolutionary creativity. From hoverflies disguising as bees to octopuses that can mimic various species, nature has developed elegant solutions to complex survival problems. This phenomenon also reminds us that in nature, appearances can be deceiving. Not everything that looks dangerous is truly dangerous, and not everything that looks harmless is truly safe. This is an ongoing evolutionary game between predators and prey, with each side continuously developing new strategies. The study of mimicry overly enriches our understanding of the natural world, but also has practical applications. Modern camouflage technology, development of color-changing robots, and even human communication strategies can learn from animal mimicry principles. Most importantly, mimicry shows how interconnected life on Earth is. Each species doesn't live in isolation, but within a complex web of interactions. When we understand and appreciate this complexity, we also better understand the importance of preserving biodiversity for the continuation of life on our planet.